This is the second part of the IOBox Value Advanced tutorial. An IOBox Value Advanced has three input pins, and two of those are hidden. If you look at Hair Inspector, you see slice offset, X input value, and I input value. Now, the light gray squares here indicate that they are hidden but connectable. This means, although I do not see a pin, when I hover above my node, it reads here on the top left slice offset. And somewhere in the middle, I read X input value. Most of the times, an IOBox value is one dimensional, meaning you only can input or output one value. Of course, we can input a spread and output a spread, but that is not what I mean with one dimensional. It is a good habit for one dimensional values to always use the I input pin and the I output pin, because those pins are visible. I could use the X pin as input. I could just right click and change it. And then I should use the X output pin as well. As you see, the value 0.93, here it's also 0.93, the value is passed on correctly. It is just that my IOBox is showing me a zero, so this method is a bit useless. So better stick with the I input value pin, because we all do that and that's the way to go. Now let's look at the help file again. I select the node and press F1. Here we see, at the bottom, these nice looking I.O. boxes. And these are two-dimensional, because they have an X value and an I value. Now I can connect an I.O. box value advanced to the X output and to the I output. So let's do that. One for the X output and one for the I output. We only see the first slice now. So let me figure out what the first slice is. It's this one. Okay, now, so if I move up or down, you saw that the I output value was changing. And if I move from the left to the right, you see the X output value is changing. We can use this IO box to position our objects, for example, connected to the translate X and translate I of a transform node. The range of this movement is set here in Hair Inspector with minimum and maximum. Let's make our one dimensional slider first. This is a one dimensional slider because we can only get an I value. First I close the help file, so I just press Ctrl W. I don't want to save it. Okay, I'm first going to make my slider. And after that, I'm going to decide how many I want. Okay, what do I need for a slider? I don't care how it looks yet. I do, however, want to show the slider. So I right-click to turn that on. And if I make my slider a bit bigger, well, higher in this case, the sliding is going to be a bit easier. I also want to set a range in which between my slider works. So let's make a slider that goes from minimum 0 to maximum 1. And now I already have a working slider. I can right-click and drag up or down, and you see we got a nice moving slider. Now you might notice that I need to drag a long way to set my slider, and this is where my slider behavior pin is useful. If I right click here and set it to slider, the slider works a bit smoother now. Okay, let's pretend we want to make the slider to look like a crossfader, you know, like you see on DJ mixers or a video mixer. Well, all I need to do is change the slider constraints from SCX to SCY. And now I got a crossfader, or a horizontal slider. Now, the thing is, when I want to get my values and use them for something else, a slider set to slider constraint I, I need the output connected to the hidden X output pin. So to make it a bit easier, let's select the slider, go to Hair Inspector, and right click here until the X output value box is dark gray. And now you can see that a pin is appeared here. So this IO box now has two output pins, one for X and one for Y. So let's make an IO box value advance. I right click, move my mouse away, and another one, and connect it. I can read the values from this IO box in my other IO boxes. Although the slider is represented by the X output pin, if I right-click on the slider and I move up or down, you might see that the I output value pin is also still working. But since we set the slider constraint to slider constraint X, the slider is represented by the X output value pin. If I select my slider again and I set the slider constraints to none, I now have one little dot that represents our X and Y location on the slider. So now we have one I/O box, but we are able to get two values, an X and an Y value, and like magic, we can see those values inside our I/O box. Okay, let's increase the slice count of this I/O box. I make it two columns, two rows, and I put the slice mode to Coles Rose Pages. So now I have four of these X and Y sliders. And if I turn on the grid, you can see the boundaries of each slider. Oh, and please note that I have connected an I/O box value advanced, but these only output the value of the first slice, and not of the second slice. So let me select them both, put the columns count to 2, and the rows count to 2, and make it a bit bigger. And now we can see our 4 X values and our 4 Y values. Okay, let me take this one step further. I select my sliders again, left click. Then I set my slider alignment to none. Now I can move my sliders all over this I/O box and even outside the boundaries of the grid. So I can put them all in this last I/O box. So now showing the grid is a bit useless and showing the value is a bit messy. So I turn them both off. Okay, now I got a little problem because I'm not sure which of these is the first slice or the second slice. So now it might be a good time to turn on the Show Connections pin. And one of these two is my first slice. This is my last slice. And this is my first slice. And then this should be my second slice, and yes it is. If I want to make sure that one slice is not bigger or smaller than its neighbor, I can set the slider alignment. I can set it to neighbor X or neighbor Y. The X value is not getting bigger than its neighbor, or the Y value is not getting bigger or smaller than its neighbor. But let me turn this to neighbor X. And now I cannot push my sliders beyond the boundary of their neighbors. You see, I move to the right and I cannot go any further. But if I was to move this one to the right, then I can move this one, my first slice, further again. And the same goes, of course, for slider alignment Y. Under the slider behavior, we also see toggle and bang. But these two are not useful anymore, since we can just right-click on the patch and make a toggle, or we right-click and make a bang. So this is a toggle, I can turn it on or off, and this is a bang that goes on for one frame only. These slider behaviors, bang and toggle, are just a legacy of older versions of VVVV. Well, I hope you're still awake. For our next tutorial, let's just have some fun. We are going to make a pretty scene using these I/O boxes, some colors and some other objects. It's going to be a big recap of all my previous tutorials. And then we are going to explore the magical world of the textures. So, see you then.